Alright, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And very good afternoon. Welcome to online preview session by Putra Business School. We would like to introduce to you Putra Business School and also the MBA program that will be offering at Turin very soon, inshallah. I would like to first introduce myself. I'm Professor Dr. Zulkarnain Yusof, the President and CEO for Putra Business School. On my right is the Director for Marketing, Madam Badani. On my left is Professor Huam, who is the Director for MBA program with the red shirt. Is Madam Nadia, who is the Director for Learning Liaisons. Okay, I would like to once again welcome everyone to this preview session, online preview session. So hopefully after this session, you will know Putra Business School and you will understand the content of our MBA program. Thank you very much for joining us. And thank you very much for your intention to join our MBA program at Putra Business School. So, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Once again, and good afternoon. Yeah. So, we would like to present a PowerPoint regarding Putra Business School. Okay, so Putra Business School is a university established by University Putra Malaysia, and we are offering postgraduate program in business and management, namely PhD and masters, yeah, including the MBA. It is a non-profit organization. And it was established by Ministry of Higher Education, supported by Ministry of Higher Education, to be groomed as a top business school in the region in 2012. Next. We have started MBA program since 1997. And in 2012, we were accredited by AACSB, which is an American-based accreditation for business school. For your information, there is only 6% of business school all over the world accredited by AACSB. In 2015, we were accredited by ABES 21, which is Japanese-based accreditation. And in 2018, July 19, we were re-accredited by AACSB. Next. So the first president was Professor Dr. Arfa Saleh. I'm the second president until today. Next. We are very strongly linked with University Putra Malaysia. As I said, University Putra Malaysia, which is a research university, is a public university, established Putra Business School as the private private entity, and we are very much related to University Putra Malaysia in various ways, where the Vice Chancellor of UPM and the Deputy Vice Chancellor, they are the permanent member or acting as the representative from UPM to own the Putra Business School. Next. This is going to be the sample of diploma or MBA degree, yeah, granted by Putra Business School once the student has completed the program. Yeah, so you can see the AACSB logo is there, and okay, all right. Upon graduation, PBS student receive a certificate in the format shown on the screen. Yeah. The embedded Universiti Putra Malaysia logo reflects the fraternal relationship between Universiti Putra Malaysia and Putra Business School. These are the list of our board of directors. Consists of Vice Chancellor of UPM, Deputy Vice Chancellor of UPM, representative from UPM board, and also some representative from the industries. Next. These are the board members of Putra Business School. Next. There is also a board of governors overseeing and overlooking, monitoring the development and also the progress of the curriculum offered by Putra Business School, chaired by the Vice Chancellor of UPM. Next. Okay. These are the pictures for the Board of Governors. University Management Committee, as you can see, my picture is there. And then number two is Datuk Muhammad Fadil Hashim, Head of Operations. And then we have Professor Dr. Sazali Abdul Wahab, the Director of a Thesis Program. Professor Huam is the Director for Non-Thesis Program or MBA. Madam Siti Badani is the Director for Corporate Communication and Marketing. And Wan Nadia is Director for Learning Liaisons. In PBS, we do appoint Professor of Practice from among a very prominent practitioners in the industry. For example, we have a former Chief Minister of a state, whose name is Datuk Sri Diraja Dr. Zamri. And then we also have Datuk Hapsa, who is the non-executive chairman for one of the, I would say, the largest pharmacy company in the country. And also, next, former Director General of Public Service Malaysia, Tan Sri Borhan. CEO of Bank Rakyat, one of the biggest bank in the cooperative bank in the country. Datuk Rosman also is our professor of practice. Dr. Ting. So the role of professor of practice are to share the latest development and the latest experience from the industries with our student and the university community. Next. All right. So some of you might not be familiar. What is AACSB? Yeah. So AACSB is the Association to Advance Collegiate School of Business. It is a global non-profit membership organization of educational institutions, business, and other entities devoted to the advancement of management education. AACSB provides internationally recognized specialized accreditation for business and accounting programs at the bachelor's, master's, and doctoral level. And AACSB accreditation is very well known worldwide as the longest standing, most recognized form of specialized or professional accreditation an institution and its business program can earn. So you can notice that most of the top business school in the world, they are accredited by AACSB. Yeah. Next. ABES 21, Alliance on Business Education and Scholarship for Tomorrow, a 21st century organization, or ABES 21, founded in 2005. And then this is a global knowledge network and considered an urgent concern to develop system to enhance the quality of management education at the business school. Yeah. So. So the ABES 21 is Japanese-based accreditation for business and management programs. Next. Okay, our MBA program also are certified by Chartered Management Institute, or CMI. CMI is the only chartered professional body for management and leadership, and remains the only organization able to award chartered manager status. Chartered Management Institute is an accredited professional institution for management based in the United Kingdom. So all of the MBA graduate will be receiving the CMI certification upon the graduation. Next. So this is the sample for CMI certificate. Next. These are the list of PBS academic team. So we have more than 60% full professors, yeah, at Putra Business School from various specialization, management, marketing, accounting, entrepreneurship. Next. Strategic management, finance, audit, economics. So we have about 25 academic teams at PBS. In PBS, we normally blend together the strength of the academic and the strength of the industry. So you can see that many of the lecturers, they were exposed and they were practitioners before. And at the same time, we also work very closely with the professional bodies. Next. If you look at the EDU Universal Best Masters ranking in Malaysia, so you can see that the programs related to management and management and finance and accounting, we are ranked quite well. Okay, next. Now I'm going to pass the floor to Professor Huam to explain the MBA program.
Yes, good afternoon, everyone. So basically now I'm going to introduce to you our MBA program, which is industry driven program, as well as that we have industry experience and knowledgeable staff, like what just now Prof Zo showed to you, our academic team. Okay, next. Okay, basically this is, I'm going to show you the academic calendar. Okay, we are supposed to start next, actually early September. So that will be 7 September. That will be our first lecture. Okay, this will be our September trimester, followed by the January trimester will be on 4th of January. Okay, next. And then May trimester next year, 2020-2021, will be starting 3rd May 2021. And then September trimester will be starting 6 September 2021. So actually, we are showing the four trimester. Okay. Next. Okay, so basically now I'm going into detail about general management. So basically, this is the entry requirement. Okay, you need to have a recognized bachelor degree with CGPA of at least 7.75 or its equivalent. Or you can have a recognized bachelor degree with CGPA below than 2.75, but not lower than 2.5. Also will be considered. Okay, but it has to be based on a strict internal assessment. It could be an interview, portfolio, or test. Or a bachelor, a recognized bachelor degree with a CGPA below 2.5 also will be considered, provided that you have a minimum of 5 years working experience. Okay, these will be the three main entry requirements. Next, Okay, now I'm showing the program structure for the MBA General Management. So basically for the first trimester, we are going to, you will be studying three subjects, okay? The first one will be ACC 7101, Accounting for Decision Making, and then ECO 7101, Business Economics, and HPM 7101, Human Centrality in Organization. These will be the first three subjects that you have to take. Followed by the trimester, that one later on. Okay, this one later on. You can. We are going to send the slide to them as well, right? Okay, the student will have the slide as well, right? One, but are they going to have all this, the program structure? They are going to have it. Okay, that's good. The trimester is three semester. It's about the line there. Actually, it's three subjects. Okay, maybe I will just further elaborate on this. For the first trimester, you'll be taking three subjects. For the second trimester, you will be taking three subjects. And for the third trimester, you'll be taking three subjects. And followed by trimester four, you'll be taking three. Trimester five, you'll be taking three subjects also. And then the last semester actually is a, you have to continue doing your project paper. So basically, you are going to complete within six trimesters. Okay. Apa? Yeah, got prerequisite. Yes, some got prerequisite. That is a prerequisite. Okay, next. Honey, thanks. Okay, this actually is the proposed class timetable. Okay, meaning that I think just now Puan Bat also mentioned, I think in the previous meeting, the first class will be on 8th of September. Okay, okay, your class will be from 8 p.m. to, no, your time is 5 p.m., right? Their time is 5 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. 5:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. Our time is 8:30 p.m. to 11. Malaysia time is 8:30 p.m. to 11 p.m. Okay, so your time is 3 hours earlier. Okay, 3 hours earlier. So this is actually the proposed class timetable, and you are going to have a study week. Okay, and then the final examination will be on 11, 12, and 13 December 2020. Okay, next, honey. So basically, this is actually the proposed three classes that you have to take for your first trimester. Business economic will be taught by Dr. Ida, okay, on Tuesday. And then accounting for decision making will be taught by Dr. Ahmad Razman on Wednesday night. And then human centrality in organization will be taught by Prof. Dr. Sazali, okay, on Friday night. Friday evening. Okay. Next. Ani. So basically, this is a fee structure. Okay. The full fee is $8,000. Okay. The full fee. And actually, for the first intake, honey, you will be getting 20% discount. Meaning that for those who are taking the trimester intake, they will be paying only 6,000 for the total fees. Okay, we are going to give 20% discount to the first cohorts, okay, MBA students in your country. Okay, next. Okay, so every student actually will automatically become the member of this Putra Student Association. So the objective of having this Putra Student Association is to represent the interests of the students and also to act as a channel of communication in dealing with the college and other bodies, and also to promote and protect the welfare of its members. Okay, basically, this is the main purpose of forming this Putra Student Association. Next, honey. Okay, this actually is our PBS international collaborations. We collaborate with universities from Japan, from Taiwan, from Pakistan, from France, you see, all over the world. Okay, so this is a collaboration. Next, honey. Okay. So usually we encourage students to take part in any international business competition. You see, so usually our students actually, they did well in this type of competition. Usually they will get winner or maybe second runner up, whatever. So they did very well in all these international business competition. So as our student, usually we will encourage you to take part as well later on. Okay. So basically, I can see that, okay, from 2016, next slide. Until 2018, you see, you can see that actually our student actually won so many prizes, okay, in this type of international business competition. Okay, next, honey. Okay, this actually our PBS alumni. Okay, we have students from all over the world actually. Okay, honey. Okay, then we also organize industrial talks as well. Like, for example, we have this Datuk Nora actually from Maybank. Okay, Maybank is one of the most prominent bank in Malaysia. Okay, Maybank. Okay, and then we have someone from Petronas. Okay, to give a talk. Okay, next, honey. And we have someone also from Microsoft Malaysia. And also we have even some professor, one professor actually, Dr. Lalit from University of Oxford, okay, to share the topic of science of new technologies and art of transformational leadership with our students. Okay, next, honey. Okay, and then just now, I think Prof. Zul, our CEO and president, mentioned about professor of practice, right? So this actually, they already give talks, you see. Most of the actually professor of practice, actually we invite them to give talk to our students. Okay, next, honey. Okay, and also we have PBS conferences as well. Okay, I know that actually you will be studying online, but we do encourage you to come to Malaysia to attend our conferences as well, or colloquium. Okay, you can. We welcome you to attend our colloquium or conferences. Okay, honey, next. And these are actually some of the students' activities. Okay, activities. Okay, next, honey. And these are among the events, okay, and activities during and after the COVID-19 movement control order. Okay. For example, we have our virtual registration day and orientation. Next, honey. Online classes. So basically, all of you will be attending online classes, huh? Okay. And then next, honey. And we also have online Viva and proposal defense. This actually is meant for Master of Science students and also PhD students. Okay, next, honey. And we have potential student interview also using online platform. Okay, honey. And virtual open day, okay, we are using an online platform as well. Honey, next. And our students, okay, we're talking about actually our students' health, well-being actually is always our top priority. This is actually what we did during the MCO time, okay? This is what we did. We give food to our international students especially. Okay, next, honey. And we have also memorandum understanding between PBS, also using online platform as well. Next, honey. Okay, basically this is the one of the e-summer course. Okay, I think recently we just had it, I think last month, right? Last month. Okay, also online as well. Next, honey. This also another one, also online. Also online. Next, honey. Okay, these are the recent activities that we have. Okay, with Ayah Selangor, as well as, Selangor Water. Selangor Water, actually. Selangor Water. Okay, this is what we had recently. Next, honey. Okay, this is also another activity that we had, okay, online, through online platform. Next, honey. I think that's all. Thank you so much. Okay, so right now, I think it's Q&A time, right? Okay, Q&A session now. Okay, thank you so much. Yeah, maybe I would like to say something before I pass this mic to. Okay, I would like to introduce you a very important person. If you do your MBA, you study your MBA here. So she's none other than Madam Wani. Madam Wani, can you just show your hand to them? Bye-bye. Okay, one Wani. Madam Wani is a very important person. Okay, thank you so much.
Okay. Yeah.
Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Tong. I'm the finance manager of Putra Business School. Okay, for future payment, okay, you can deal with me.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
First, plan line.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. I'm Ismailiza from Emission Unit. I'm under Marketing and Corporate Communication Department. So after this, I will meet you regarding the application and all the offer letters. Thank you.
Money.
Cost coordinator. Say something.
I'm Wani. So for the decision course, you may liaise with me. Okay, thank you.
All right. I hope all of you have got some important insight on Putra Business School and the MBA programs that will be offered at Turin. And if you have any question, please do not hesitate to ask, yeah, regarding anything. Was it clear, the presentation?
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Do you hear me? My name is Ibrahim. Assalamu alaikum, everybody.
Walaikum salam.
My question is, it says there is no any exam, there is no any examination for the master's degree. So everybody can have equal rights to study on master's degree. But my work experience is not 5 years. It is three years, more than 3 years. So, do I have any chance in order to get to study on the Putra University online here in Uzbekistan?
Okay. So actually, working experience is required if the CGPA is below 2.5. So if the CGPA for your undergraduate is above 2.5, there is no need for working experience.
The grading system.
Yeah. Is it clear?
Yes, it is clear. So when we can get the tuition invoices for the fees?
in order to study.
Okay. Tuition invoice, technically, yeah, once you are given the offer letters and you will be registering for the first trimester, mm-hmm. early September, next month, or next week to be exact.
Next week.
So, yeah, so you will be given the invoice for the first payment, first trimester.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. So you don't have to pay the whole sum. You just pay for that particular trimester.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's good.
Yeah, it is by trimester, yeah?
Mm-hmm, I got it.
Yes, any other question, please?
Hi, everyone. Sorry for interruption. Hi, everyone. My name is Alisher. I also would like to ask some questions. First questions, could you tell us in what country you are providing MBA programs?
Can you repeat that question, please?
My question was, I'm asking about in what country you are providing MBA program.
Yes, we.
I mean, additional from Uzbekistan, in what other country you're providing your MBA program?
Okay. All right. Actually, Uzbek is the first country that we are offering our MBA program abroad. We are also in the midst of discussion and finalizing to offer our MBA program in Dhaka, Bangladesh. Yeah. And we also have, of course, other plans, but have not finalized yet.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
Am I answering your question? I hope I answered.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, why don't you show your faces? Don't tak tunjuk muka.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes.
My name is Damir. And my question is, could you share this presentation file with somebody in Turin University in order to...
Oh, yes, no problem. We can send these slides to you. We send to Turin and Turin will distribute. Is that okay?
Okay. No problem. Thank you.
Yeah.
Also, another question, please. I'm not so familiar with SGPA. Could you please inform us how is it calculated? Okay. I mean, I just would like to understand. I have a minimal 2.75 or no, but actually, I also have more than 5 years experience. But anyway, just would like to understand how it's calculated. Thank you.
CGPA is technically cumulative grade point average. That is the points that normally the undergraduate student will achieve during their undergraduate study. So there are two systems. Some system follow 4.0 as the maximum CGPA. And in some countries, they might have 5.0. So maybe you can tell me in Uzbek, normally, the CGPA is based on 4.0 or 5.0. Maybe one of you can answer. In Turin, for example, do you Do you have CGPA system?
Yes, in Turin we have such system. Please, Jalaluddin, could you explain how we do calculation? We have 100%, it's 110 points. It's 100% of what you can get in Turin Polytechnic University. By Uzbek system, it's a 100 bell system. It means medium, all scores, calculate all scores and dividing for number of subjects. For example, for A, it's a 86, from 86 to 100, it's a A. Okay. If you compare with the American system, European is ECTS system, it's 110 scores. Jaludin, could you explain it in detail? Jaludin?
Okay, yeah, something like that actually. If in our system the maximum is 4.0, meaning that for example in the trimester, if one student score all A's in the subjects, yeah, A for first subject, A for second subject, and A for the third subject, that means the CGPA will be 4.0 for that trimester. If the grade is B, if the grade is B for all subject, then the CGPA will be 3.0. Yeah, 3.0. Okay, so that is how more or less we calculate the CGPA. It is related to the score, whether it is A or whether it is B plus, or B or B minus or C plus, yeah. So the maximum, if every subject is A, then it will be 4.0. But for some countries, if all subjects are A, the maximum score could be 5.0. So it depends on the system in the country. All right. But there is a formula to convert, yeah, from 5.0 to 4.0.
Okay, got it, thank you. Just additional question regarding CGPA. For instance, I didn't provide the attachment to diploma where shown all my marks. Is it means I should provide it? Or I have experience more than 5 years. Is it means I should provide it, my diploma attachment or not? Thank you. The question was clear, or I should to repeat again, please?
Okay, when you say diploma, does that mean bachelor degree?
Yep, yep. But diploma, it means a bachelor degree. You're
bachelor
right.
Bachelor degree, yeah? Okay. Yep. If you're not sure, you can give the related information to us and we will analyze and we will technically conclude, yeah? Or you can pass that to Turin so that Turin, our partner there, can advise, yeah? What is actually your CGPA score, yeah, based on 4.0. If Turin is not sure, you can forward to us and we will advise, inshallah.
It's
yeah?
In English, yeah? Not in Uzbek.
Of course. yeah, the information has to be in English. Otherwise, we will not understand.
Okay,
and it. If you have working experience, you can always state or provide the proof, yeah, in the application. You can always submit to us. So that can be additional evidence.
Just a question regarding working improvement. Is it okay if I will provide that, if I provided labor book or something like this, documents will be approved for my work experience, or should I provide some special documents for improvement?
I think a letter from your employer is good enough.
Okay, got it. Thank you. And yeah. Additional questions. For instance, my bachelor degree was with honor. It means the all marks was 5, and the maximum score is 5. So in this case, I think I don't need to provide it my diploma attachments and to calculate my CGPA score, or no?
Send the transcript to us.
Okay, yeah. Got it. Thank you.
Send the transcript. It is in English, right?
Unfortunately, no. It is in our local language, but I can translate it. No problem.
Please. We need the translated version, yeah?
Yep, got it. And sorry, additional questions. What is the deadline to providing the transcriptions?
Excuse me. When it comes to translation, it is necessary that whatever translation you do, it must be verified by another authority or perhaps from your university itself. It cannot be merely been translated by yourself and you pass it over to us. This is the practice at international level. Thank you.
You got it. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Boleh tak? Kita bagi empowerment to Turin. Yes. Yes, sir. We empower Turin to verify the translation. Okay? Certify the translation. So we empower Turin to do that. But not the person himself doing the translation. Okay?
Actually, it was a good offer to us. I just would like to say to thank you to Turin for supporting us.
Yes. Are you all engineers?
No, Jamshid Inayat Hajaev, Rector. From applicants we get, we analyze that some people is coming from finance.
Mm-hmm.
It's about 4 or 5. And we have one person whose nature education, bachelor education is a translator.
Okay, good, very good. Yeah, MBA program technically can be for anyone from any degree.
Mm-hmm. You think in...
I have one question. Sorry.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sorry. Go on.
Long question. Huh? Yes, please.
Here, people works in the different position in governmental works. So my question is there free attendance for the classes?
What do you mean by free attendance?
Attendance is compulsory?
Compulsory, how many percent?
Oh, okay.
80%.
Yeah, attendance is important, yes. You have to attend the classes. Normally the practice here, the student is expected to attend at least 80% of the classes. Yeah, of course, 100% is best. Yeah, better. But if, you know, there are, for example, special reasons, you know, meetings or working, and you're not able to attend one or two classes, you know, at least you must complete 80%, 80 of the total attendance. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Got it. Clear.
You're most welcome. Nak cakap sekarang, tapi dah mention tadi dalam entry tadi. So during your undergraduate, the programs were delivered in English. For yeah. Oh, okay. Programs. Okay. All right. Zoom. We'll be using Zoom because so far the best is technically Zoom in terms of clarity and, you know, interaction. We find that Zoom is still the best. Yeah. Alternatively, we might use Google Meet, but we have subscribed Zoom application. Is that okay? Very good.
Also, one question from my side. Is these online lessons will be downloaded or uploaded to some, databases that students can have access to re-watch these video lessons and maybe to prepare for examination for other cases or who missed this video? Is it possible to upload in a server somewhere or share?
Mm-hmm. Very good question. Yes, all sessions will be recorded and student can always refer to the file. Yeah, anytime.
Let me ask a question, please.
Yes, sir.
How long are you planning to deliver online classes?
You mean per session?
Yeah.
Per session. How long means the length of the session or what?
No, I mean for the first year. How long?
First year, December. Oh, okay.
Online lessons, it will be only...
Oh, okay. Actually, the plan for this program is not online. Is you know, face to face. We plan to send our lecturers there, yeah. But because of the COVID-19, because of the movement control order, so we deliver the classes online. So probably, if everything is fine, starting next January, we will deliver, we'll fly there and deliver the lecture directly to you in Turin, Uzbekistan, inshallah.
Inshallah. And one more question. I have checked your official website and some several study programs. And the question is, why did you choose the general management study program, not like finance, economics, or human resource?
Yeah, very, very good question. Yeah, from our experience, most of the students prefer general management because, you know, somehow general management technically can accommodate more people. However, I understand that some of you might have interest in certain specialization, yeah. So actually, for general management, there are many choices in terms of specialization. So when it comes to specialization, probably what we can do is to get the consensus among the student what subjects you would like to take for specialization. Is it finance or corporate governance or marketing? Yeah. So we'll follow the majority. That would be, I think, the easiest. Okay. I'm talking about specialization in the general management. Of course, the core courses, you know, you cannot choose. You have to take all. Project paper or dissertation, we leave it to you. You can choose topics related to your interest, maybe finance, maybe related to marketing, yeah, or accounting even. You see that there are core courses everyone has to take, and then specialization, there are four, right? There are four courses in specialization. So now, there are five courses for specialization. So when it comes to choosing the courses in specialization, I think we can discuss, yeah, among the student, what subjects you would prefer to take. Is it clear? Good. You are most welcome to come here. We are more than happy to receive you here. Yeah, just, you know, inform us earlier and we will arrange for your visa. Yeah.
And are you planning to offer different study programs, MBA, like, as I said, finance or accounting or marketing?
Okay. Technically, we want to introduce various specialization also, but you know, the constraint is because we do not know how many students are going to enroll. Okay, it depends on the number of enrollment, yeah,
And because Turin is not our main campus, so the number of students are limited. So it all depends on the crowd. Yeah, if the crowd is enough, we can probably allow different specialization courses. Yeah, because practically, you know, when we want to send our lecturer there, so the minimum number of students must be there. Okay, so if the number is not enough, then it is not economic to offer so many different courses for the smaller groups. Okay, mm-hmm. So. Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, thank you very much. I just like to add here a few points that at PBS we are planning to introduce many current subjects that we like to share with all our brothers from your country, especially the among the current subjects, for example, financial technology. Now, I think all over the world are using technology in their financial system. And we have already introduced this subject to us, and we like to offer to all your students. That is a fintech. And then a second subject that we are planning to offer, in fact, we already offer Islamic economic and Islamic finance, which now become very popular in the world. As you are fully aware now, the Islamic Sukuk bond is now becoming trillions of US dollar all over the world. And Malaysia now is the global center for the Sukuk bond. Sukuk Financial Center is Malaysia, and the standard is in Malaysia also under our INSEF. I think you're fully aware of that. INSEF is one of the institutions that involved in establishing the standard, Islamic financial standard. And also at the same time, in terms of Islamic insurance, we are planning to introduce very soon. Islamic, inshallah, we're going to introduce to students who are interested to further their study in Islamic insurance. Okay? Islamic economic, Islamic finance, Islamic insurance. And then also at the same time, we're also planning to introduce the halal management program, which now Malaysia is the global center of the halal management. And we have just have a long discussion to establish MBA halal management. I think my CEO deliberate further on that because he was the one involved directly in establishing this MBA in what we call this halal management. And now there are so many inquiry of students overseas who are interested to come to Malaysia to do halal management program, MBA. And now I think you are fully aware halal market now has been growing at a quantum leap. From time to time. I think the quantum now probably will be reaching to $1 trillion, the market of halal meat all over the world. I think you're fully aware in the world today, the Islam population is about 1.7 billion people, Islam. And imagine the market there, how much the market, halal market, especially Middle East and also in Asian countries. Thank you very much for that.
Thank you. Yes, any other question?
Yeah, yes. Maybe only.
Yes, that is right. So what we suggest is to actually help the applicants, yeah, to accommodate them and to make the process easier. So all the student, the potential applicants submit the information to Turin first. And Turin will do the pre-screening based on the criteria that we have told you. And then you will submit or forward those who are qualified to us. Yeah. And then we'll inform you. Okay. And then after that, the student can proceed with the online application. Okay, so the online application is necessary so that your information, student information, the student academic backgrounds will be uploaded and will be in our system. And very soon, I think within 3 days,
three working days,
you will receive the offer letter. Okay, if all information are enough and fulfill our requirement.
In fact, now I think we have a plan. We might need to go there, right? I think that is the plan. So we still don't know yet. Maybe we have to go there. Still remember earlier that we did mention that we might go to Turin to conduct the exam, you see, for 3 days. You see, no? We might go there or we might do online. It all depends. You see, no? We don't know yet. But it's either final as online or face-to-face, you see. You see, so we already fixed the date right just now. I think it's 12, 13, 14 December. I cannot remember already. That's the date that for a final exam. Is it not? The final exam. So we will get our staff. Maybe Madam Wani will be going there or what? I'm not so sure yet. Is it not? We might go there and to conduct the final assessment. So the student has to have to sit in the class to take the exam. This is our plan. Okay? Yeah.
So we hope that we can travel to Uzbek very soon so that we can conduct the exam there. Yeah. Otherwise, we'll resort to take home exam or open book exam or assignment. Okay. Yes, actually our degree is recognized worldwide, especially because we are AACSB accredited. Yeah, so you can use the certificate to further study abroad technically, no problem. In fact, at the moment, we have one American who is doing the MBA.
Two Americans
that do the MBA at PBS. Yeah. Why? Because they know we are accredited by AACSB. Yes.
Azerbaijan. One alumni.
Azerbaijan is your neighboring country. Azerbaijan. Yeah, because we have two students from Azerbaijan.
One alumni, one current.
One already completed and the other one is still completing. So you speak different languages, yeah?
I speak Russian.
Almost similar. Very good. Okay. All right. Yeah. Inshallah. Yeah, I also would like to express my sincere gratitude and appreciation to Turin and to all potential applicants and students for joining this session. Yes, exactly like what was mentioned just now, once the pandemic is over or reduced, then we will go there directly. Yeah? We will send the lecturers to Uzbek to deliver the lecture face-to-face, inshallah. Yeah. So we hope to see you soon, inshallah, as part of PBS community, joining PBS officially, inshallah, very soon. And thank you so much for joining this session. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye bye.